Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today we only have a little bit of SpaceX news and mostly Boca Chica updates. But there's lots of action to look at with SN7.1 burst, SN8 flaps and even Super Heavy has been spotted, plus more. So let's head straight in and get up to date. Starting off today's video, we have a new date in which to expect the next launch of 60 Starlink satellites. Starlink 12 was expected to launch multiple times recently but had to be delayed due to various reasons. However, as you can see on the SpaceX fans website, it's now expected to lift off on Sunday 27th of September. Also on there is currently a date set for the next GPS-free launch. It's currently expected to lift off on Wednesday 30th of September, but remember, these dates could change at any point. Turns out that the details for Tom Cruise and Doug Liman to go and film on the ISS have been finalised. Along with a NASA astronaut and potentially one other person, the Crew Dragon capsule carrying the men will launch in October 2021. Starting off the Boca Chica updates, we recently saw that all of the rebar cages had been sleeved. Not really progressed much as engineers continue to work on the sleeves, but here's the latest view of the new orbital launch mount. At the landing pad, work has been going on recently. Here you can see what they are doing at the moment. Looking at the other launch mounts with pad B, you can see that the thrust simulator has been removed since the SN7.1 testing. Although the pad A mount has since had the addition of the same thrust simulators for testing the next Starship to be placed on the mount. Over at the production site, the high bay for the Super Heavy boosters is still under construction. This great shot shows both BlueZilla and the new red crane that recently arrived. Whilst they've been working on getting the walls put up, there are also engineers working up top as they continue installing the roof. The roll lift was seen heading back to the launch area after recently assisting SN5 and SN6 into the high bay. As a lot of you will know, yesterday there was a Tesla Battery Day event in which Elon Musk actually gave a little Starship information. Here's what he said.
Over time, we'll see all modes of transport, with the ironic exception of rockets, transition to sustainability, or to electric, basically. On the rocket front, what we're planning to do is, like about 80% of Starship is liquid oxygen, we're actually already running a power line to be able to use wind power to create the liquid oxygen.
With some recent bad weather over in Boca Chica, lots of components were moved back into tents. Here's a bunch of ring stacks. Spotted hanging outside in the construction yard is a strapped down 3-ring stack. Behind the tents by the windbreaker, the nose cones were also recently moved into fabrication tents. However, since then they have been moved back outside as SpaceX cracks on with constructing more in the tent. With SpaceX storing and working on ring stacks all over the place, here we have another sitting in a tent hooked up to be moved soon. Not sure if this ring stack is the same as what we just saw, but you can see another stack was moved out of a tent. Now, moving on to SN7.1 as it was continuing to wait for its demise, with SpaceX planning to test how high they can get the pressure before it pops. On Monday through to Tuesday, both Mary and the NASA spaceflight team hosted a livestream for over 7 hours as we were hoping for a pop. However, after 2 attempts, the tank was seen venting and it was clear that there had been another abort. Then, after Mary and NSF streaming for more than 21 hours combined with all the testing attempts, it finally happened. Throughout the night and morning, from Tuesday through to Wednesday, SpaceX filled the tank with liquid nitrogen. Then, once they were ready, they closed off the top valves and started increasing the pressure to the point of failure. So now, once the area is safe again, they'll work to get SN7.1 out of there. Looking at the next Starships, for a while now, the SN8 tank has been stacked and prepared for testing. As of recently, it was also moved outside the mid-bay, sporting its aerosurface covers for the fins. With SN8 now outside the midbay, they can commence with installing the fins. Here you can see them lifting one for installation. Then, just in front of the midbay, you can see that they recently installed the first fin to the body of Starship SN8. Here is the latest build diagram from Brendan for SN8. We have a bit of SN9 with the pretty much complete upper bulkhead and ring stack which were recently moved outside. SpaceX are probably going to have SN9 stacked fully quite soon. As well as SN8 and SN9, the Starship SN10 tank is also continuing to progress nicely. Here you can see a new lower bulkhead with its thrust puck sitting on a sleeving mount. Then you can see that a ring stack moved outside was lifted and the bulkhead and rings were sleeved together. Now they will weld these together to form part of the SN10 aft section. So this is the SN10 build diagram, and parts for this tank are coming together nicely and at an amazing pace. The last Starship serial number to show you for this video is SN11. Here you can see that the leg skirt was hooked up to be moved. Then it was seen being moved around the yard and into a fabrication tent to be worked on further. Here we also have the SN11 build diagram once again from Brendan. Hopefully soon we will see more sections for this tank emerge. Finally for this video, what we have here is a brand new barrel section being moved out of the tent. Although this is no Starship section, this is the very first barrel section and a common bulkhead ring stack for super heavy. Whilst this ring stack was moved out of one fabrication tent, it was then moved back into another for further work. Of course, that also means we have a new build diagram to see for the construction of the first super heavy. This thing is going to be absolutely insane to see. None of these updates would be possible without the amazing Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, going out there and filming, so thank you. As well, thank you to the rest of the NASA spaceflight team who are all doing amazing work behind the scenes, particularly with their live streams. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.